This lesson is about identifying intercepts, and then we'll be using intercepts to graph our linear equations. All right, an intercept is a point where a graph crosses an axis. For example, if I drew this line, if that was my graph, this point would be my x-intercept, and I'm just going to abbreviate it. This point, because it's crossing the y-axis, would be called my y-intercept. This is true even if the graph is not a line. Let's suppose I have something called an ellipse. This particular graph has two x-intercepts, and it has two y-intercepts. Something that I hope you'll notice about intercepts, of course they're on the axis. If this is an x-intercept, think about that point. From the origin, you would go to the x value, but then you would not go up or down. All x-intercepts are x, 0. The y is 0 because you've not moved off the x-axis. Y-intercepts are always, you don't move right or left. You just go to the y value. So y-intercepts are all 0, y. All right, so let's use that idea as we look at our problems. Number one, it says identify all the x-intercepts, type an ordered pair, use a comma to separate as needed. All right, x-intercept. Here's the x-intercept right here. Let me switch to a color. Well, that didn't switch. All right, there's my x-intercept. And what is that ordered pair? Well, it is left 1, so that's negative 1, but it's not up or down. So it is negative 1, 0, and that's what you would type in. There's only one of them. Now, the next one says y-intercepts. Well, here's the y-intercept. For a y-intercept, you don't go right or left, so its x-coordinate is 0, and then you go up to 1. Those are my intercepts. These next two might have some multiple intercepts. The first one, all right, what are the intercepts? Now, it doesn't say specifically list the x ones and the y ones. So you can do this in any order you want. So right here, this happens to be an x-intercept. This is the point negative 5, 0, because it goes left 5, but it doesn't go up or down. If you go to this one, this is the point 0, negative 7, because you did not go right or left, but you just went down in the y direction to negative 7. The last one is positive 5, 0 for this point. Now, when you type those in there, it would be parentheses negative 5, 0, close, parentheses 0, negative 7, close parentheses, 5, 0, because it says type an ordered pair, use a comma to separate answers as needed. This particular problem did not ask you to separate them into groups of x-intercept, y-intercept. All right, let's do this one. I'm going to just move along the graph from left to right. Here's an x-intercept, and the ordered pair is negative 2, 0. Moving along the graph, here's a y-intercept. This one is 0, 2. The third one is 1, 0. And the fourth one is 3, 0. This particular graph had 1, 2, 3 x-intercepts and 1 y-intercept. Over here, this is an x-intercept, a a y-intercept, an x. You can list them in any order you want because it doesn't specify. All right, one more problem. Identify, this one separates them again. Identify all the x-intercepts. Well, there are two. The first one is negative 3 comma 0 comma. Now I have to get the other x-intercept. It's positive 3 comma 0. So that would be my listing. Then for the y-intercepts, doesn't matter which one you do first. I'm going to look at the top. That is 0 comma 5. Because to get to that location, I would not go right or left, therefore 0, but up 5, comma. And the last one is 0 comma negative 5. So that has been some practice in identifying intercepts. In our next lesson, we'll use those to graph.